Meanwhile, 12 hostages, including 10 Israelis and 2 foreign nationals, were freed by Hamas on the 5th day of a temporary ceasefire between Israel and the Hamas militants. Soon after, Israel released 30 Palestinian prisoners. Once confirmed, the total number of hostages released by Hamas since Friday would stand at 81, including 60 Israelis and 21 foreigners. Israel, meanwhile, has released over 100 Palestinian prisoners. The remaining missing Filipino in Israel, Noreline Babadilla, has been freed by Hamas militants. This was announced by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Wednesday morning. Marcos says Babadilla is safely back in Israel and the Philippine Embassy in Tel Aviv is attending to her needs. Marcos also thanked Egypt and Qatar for their crucial roles in the truce. With this development, all Filipinos affected by the war have been accounted for. Before Babadilla, another Filipino, Jimmy Pacheco, was released from Hamas captivity after 49 days. With a truce set to expire Wednesday, Palestine's envoy to the United Nations calls on the international community to help push for a permanent ceasefire to the war. Ambassador Riyad Mansour says a truce allows sincere efforts to address the humanitarian crisis in Gaza. More than 15,000 Palestinians have been killed in Israel's bombardment of Gaza, with more bodies feared buried under the rubble. Over a million more have lost their homes.
The massacres of Palestinian children, women, and men cannot resume, should not resume. You should not allow it to resume. The human conscience cannot bear it. International law, including humanitarian and human rights law, prohibits it. International law, but also the norms of humanity, demand that we act to stop this war against innocent civilians and save human lives, that we act for humanitarian aid and access throughout the Gaza Strip, the return of those displaced without delay, the end of the siege and blockade, and that we act for accountability. Nothing can ever justify war crimes, crimes against humanity, and genocide.
Israel has vowed to resume its offensive once the ceasefire is over, but it's also open to extend the truce by one day for every 10 more hostages released. The West defending itself against accusations of unfair handling of the wars in Ukraine and Gaza. Arab leaders have accused Western countries of having double standards in the conflicts, saying they have failed to provide the same support to Gaza. But NATO Chief Jens Stoltenberg says the situation in Gaza and Ukraine are different in many ways.
So upholding international law, upholding humanitarian law is important regardless of the type of conflict. Then I think it's also important to recognize that the situation in Gaza and the situation in Ukraine is different in many ways. Ukraine never posed a threat to Russia. Ukraine never attacked Russia. The Russian invasion of Ukraine was an unprovoked invasion, full-scale invasion of another country.
The weeks-long dramatic rescue in India ends successfully. All 41 construction workers walked out safe after being trapped in a collapsed tunnel in the Himalayas for 17 days. Rescuers resorted to hand digging after the machine they had been using broke down Friday. All of the rescued workers are undergoing medical examination. Pope Francis cancels his planned trip to the COP28 climate meeting in Dubai as he recovers from the effects of influenza and lung inflammation. The Vatican says the Pope had agreed not to proceed with his 3-day visit to Dubai with regret, adding they would look for ways on how the Pope could contribute to the discussions remotely. The Pope was supposed to deliver one of the keynote speeches in Dubai on Saturday and have bilateral meetings on the same day. Charlie Munger, the longtime vice chairman and second-in-command to Warren Buffett at Berkshire Hathaway, dies. He was 99. Munger died at California Hospital Tuesday, but no cause was given. In a statement, Buffett thanked Munger, saying Berkshire Hathaway could not have been built to its present status without Charlie's inspiration, wisdom, and participation. Munger had been a Berkshire vice chairman since 1978. His death, though, is unlikely to have a major impact on Berkshire, with two other vice chairmen overseeing its operations. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with the White House welcoming the extension of the humanitarian pause in Gaza.
The White House says it welcomes the extension of the humanitarian pause in Gaza. The temporary truce between Israel and Hamas is now on its fifth day to allow for the release of more Israeli hostages and Palestinian prisoners. The Biden administration hopes that Americans will be among the 20 hostages to be released next, as 8 to 9 U.S. citizens are believed to still be among those being held.
The approach that we're taking with Israel and quite frankly with our partners in the region is working. It's getting aid into people that need it. It's getting a pause in the fighting. It's getting hostages out. It's getting Americans out. And quite frankly, we continue to urge and will continue to urge the Israelis as they conduct military operations to do so with the utmost care for innocent civilian life.
The truce agreed last week was the first pause in fighting in the 7 weeks since Hamas attacked Israel, killing 1,200 people and taking about 240 hostages back into Gaza, according to Israeli tallies. Following Israel's retaliation, more than 15,000 Palestinians have been killed. Gaza's Hamas-run government says, and hundreds of thousands have been displaced.
In sports, Filipino-Salvadorian quarterback Caleb Sanchez and the St. John Bosco High School Braves fell short in their attempt to win back-to-back national championships.
Caleb Sanchez and St. John Bosco fell short 35-7 against their rivals, Modern Day, in the California Interscholastic Federation's Southern Section Championships at the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum this past Thanksgiving weekend. Battling a stout defense and injuries sustained from his 6-touchdown performance in the semifinal round, the Phil Salvadorian quarterback managed 1-touchdown pass late in the third quarter. He ended the game, his final high school game, with 172 passing yards and a pair of interceptions, both returned for touchdowns.
And finally, we hear from Connie Lacson as she is hailed as one of the most influential Filipina women in the world.
Whereas Honorary Counsel Lacson will receive the Foundation of Filipina Women's Network 2023 Most Influential Filipino Women in the World Award in the distinguished category.
The Nova Scotia legislature was among the first to congratulate Honorary Consul Consuelo Connie Lacson, who was hailed among the most influential Filipino women of 2023. Lacson was given the honor by the Filipino Women's Network, a globally recognized nonprofit organization. 2023's most influential Filipino women came from 10 different countries, and Lacson was among the three awardees from Canada. But she was the only awardee for the policy and visionary category.
This is a group of game changers. These are Filipino women who are very powerful in their own field and who have great achievements and triumphed over their obstacles.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.